Every month, a pair of satellites weigh our planet. GRACE, a joint mission of NASA and the German Space Agency, was conceived to measure changes in the Earth's gravity. But those satellites reveal something unexpected. Global freshwater reserves are declining by 324 billion cubic meters every year. And that's the equivalent of 4 Olympic-sized pools every second, enough water to meet the needs of 280 million people every year. These measurements informed our new Global Water Monitor report, revealing for the first time not only where and why freshwater is disappearing, but how we can begin to restore balance. Think of the land as a giant water bank. It stores water in different accounts, quick access ones like soil moisture, lakes and rivers, and long-term savings like groundwater and glaciers. Rain and snow refilled accounts, but evaporation, runoff, and human withdrawals take water out. When withdrawals exceed deposits, the balance drops, and the long-term reserves start to run low. Global warming, droughts, and unsustainable water and land use are driving this loss. Independent from climate change, how we use land is one of the main reasons our freshwater is disappearing. Forests and wetlands act like natural sponges, holding on to water. But when they are replaced by cities or intensive farms, water drains away much faster. The second key factor is how we manage water itself. When we pump or withdraw water faster than nature can put it back, the balance runs low. In fact, in places without glaciers, most of the freshwater loss comes from receding groundwater, which makes up nearly 70% of the total loss. This loss isn't abstract. It's jobs, harvests, and habitats. In fact, in sub-Saharan Africa, drought leaves 600,000 to 900,000 people without work every year. When rainfall declines or water is mismanaged in one country, the impacts can ripple far beyond its borders through interconnected trade networks. Freshwater depletion also raises the risk of wildfires and threatens biodiversity. Our report shows that water vulnerability hotspots are not limited to arid regions. They're emerging in places once rich in water, from southeastern Brazil to parts of Europe and Asia. Meanwhile, global water use has risen by 25% since 2000, with about one-third of that increase coming from regions already drying out. The good news is we now know where change can make the biggest difference. Improving water use efficiency in agriculture could save up to 40% of global water consumption if paired with effective monitoring and regulations to protect the savings. Our report identifies three pillars for action. We need to manage demand by using water more efficiently across agriculture, cities, and industry. We need to augment supply through reuse, recycling, water storage, and where feasible, desalination. And finally, it's important to improve water allocation by ensuring that scarce water resources are distributed efficiently and equitably. How can we turn these goals into results? From community water management to cross-border river commissions, strong governance turns plans into results. Pricing water appropriately can encourage conservation, while targeted support ensures affordability and equity. Transparent tracking of how much water is withdrawn, used, and returned builds trust and informs smarter investment. The same technologies that reveal the need for action can now guide the solution, helping us track, manage, and protect water more precisely than ever before. When nations grow crops suited to their water supply, global trade can balance the system instead of straining it. This is known as virtual water trade, the exchange of water embedded in crops and goods. and it already saved nearly 10% of global water use each year. Together, these priorities set the foundation for smarter water management and investment, connecting communities and ecosystems for a more resilient global water system. You can learn more about our planet's connected water system in the Global Water Monitoring Report, Continental Drying, a Threat to Our Common Future.